something to do with acupuncture. And he talks about how he would insert the needles into my shoulder, and it would make my muscles jump. And because my muscles are...
Follow Charlie. He's a good one to sniff out trouble. Stay close to Charlie.
Hey everybody, welcome back.
Lead the way, boy. What have you got for me? Thank you.
Possibly.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson. To settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Hey, Nate American, how you doing today?
You're not gonna get much herding done without a horse. Right, are you ready to learn how to herd some cows?
Good to hear, man.
All that back there. It must have been hard for you.
I'm doing pretty good, man. Just trying to get a hang of this whole streaming thing.
Somewhere close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked.
How are you, Miss McFarlane?
Whoa there!
Whoa! Yeah!
Where are you taking those cows?
He's got it!
Stay behind them, Mr. Moss.
That's it!
Go,
on, Mr. Marston.
Keep them moving.
Easy.
Herd the cows down the road. Pretend you know what you're doing.
Keep guessing, y'all.
Oh, sweet, man. I'll take a look at that and hear you in a second here. Thanks. I use the OBS software and it's showing me that I don't have any drop rates, man. I don't understand. That was because I am streaming through
the
Xbox
good.
App on the computer, so when I shrunk that down, it froze me up a little bit. Thank you for the feedback, though, man. I really appreciate it.
Well, hello, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarland.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. And we had outlaws, and we had drought. Smallpox, terrible winters, cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government, sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson.
Now, I got everything shut down, but the app for the Xbox and the OBS software.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. But you tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. That sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie. We got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime. Apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on. I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston.
You know,
the Taskmaster's got me listed at 20% of my memory use. That's it.
Of yours to good use. That ranch hand said there's a pack of wild horses nearby.
Come on!
Come on, boy!
I'm wondering if it's the storm in the area we have going on, too.
You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
Ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshall got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret who sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches would steal a coin off a dead man's eyes.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics.
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy the ride?
I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. And there's few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better, if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland.
It really wouldn't surprise me if my upload speed is crappy going on right now.
Let them let it.
There's the horses! Get that lasso ready!
Rope one of them for me, Marston!
Yeah!
You gonna use that rope or not? Hold tight. Coming to help you.
Good. Don't want to break him in. I gotta hold on him. Rope him. He's right there. You got this.
down. Come on. Calm yourself.
You got him. Eat it out of your hand. Nice work. I think that'll do it for today. Let's get back to the ranch.
I like your father.
I'm glad. He's quite a character.
You have a good life here. The life I want. For me and my family, I mean.
We don't have a lot anymore.
You have enough. It's one that gets so many folks in trouble.
It'll sap your spirit and make you poor. But it's straight. And it's decent.
There's no better night's sleep than after an honest day's work.
It's no wonder you look so tired, then.
Some deck must be shy of Joker, Miss McFarlane.
Who'd have thought you'd be such a natural at busting Broncos?
That was fun!
I think you could be a fine rep. Well done, Mr. Marston. These are fine horses.
Hey, Bonnie. Amos was saying some horses been spotted somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We could really do with those horses. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's head for Armadillo.
You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure ask a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a catch.
The fact that you're talking in the past says it all.
No, that's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Some, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's Stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little, well, you know, countrified.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarlane?
From a couple of cheap governesses Pa hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes, that's all. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He'd never admit it, but my Pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarlane.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much.
It's kind of painful, but she's never far from my thoughts.
There's my boys. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's drive them up the canyon where it narrows. We'll trap them there.
See you there, miss. Go. Move. Come on.
Whoa!
got you. Come on. Come on. Nearly got you. Relax now. Nearly there. Relax.
Thanks for your help today, Mr. Marston. We got some fine horses. You know, why don't you keep that stallion as your own, as a thank you from all of us?
Thank you, ma'am. He's a fine animal. Sorry, partner. Let's make this quick. Thank you.
Damn it, did the stream lock up again? Thank you.
She's gone.
Who is?
My wife. She's gone. She went out picking mushrooms in the hills near Hanging Rock, and they got her. The stories are true.
What'd the police do about it?
Oh, about as much as you'd expect. Made me fill out a form.
Beryl ain't strong, but she's a good girl. I'll see what I can do. Go. Come on.
was that they had changed the work form,
where the buffalo run, and the deer in the end of the play.
Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. You need help?
The closest doctor is in Armadillo. What is your name, friend?
John Larson.
Oh, good God! Out of the frying pan into the fire. Excuse me.
How many outlaws can a man encounter in one day?
You must have me mistaken with somebody else, friend.
The Pollard twins, Walton's gang. I know who you are. Good Lord, it's those scoundrels once again.
I'm in a bad place here.
Is that all of them? Praise me. There's still hope. Oh, coward! I implore you to please stay on the road.
What the hell happened to you?
Bandits! Hoodlums! The scoundrels robbed me blind and left me to die!
I can see that.
Once again, a victim of my own success. They see a man in a well-cut suit and this happens.
Do you know who they were?
No idea. I'm not the kind of man who has enemies.
You do now.
I give so much and still they take. We live in an uncivilized and graceless world, friend. Our maker has a funny sense of humor sometimes. Still, at least I met you, a good Samaritan in wolf's clothes. Forgive me, pain is playing rare havoc with my metaphors. How many of these hoodlums are there? I knew you'd come.
What?
I knew this wasn't my time. He has a greater purpose for me.
You're delirious and plain dumb, friend.
Fate brought you to my aid. Why else are you helping me? Is that Armadillo? Come on, hurry! Death! I embrace you.
For Christ's sakes, man, you're gonna be fine. We're nearly there.
Take me into your arms!
This is it. You're gonna make it.
Oh, where the devil are we?
Armadillo. We made it safe, you'll be happy to know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. You're a gentleman and an honor.
Coming from you, I doubt that means much, but I appreciate the civility.
I owe you, sir. And I always pay my debts. Jesus! But if I die, I'm sorry for it. If not, I'll be your man for...
Let's get you fixed up first. Then we'll decide what you're my man for.
Strength, his love for me.
Excuse me, friend. Mind if I rest up at your camp a spell?
Well, be my pleasure. Man needs a break from this desiccated land.
Thank you, mister. Say, what's that stick you got there?
Oh, y'all ain't...
Howdy, friend. I didn't know anyone lived out here. Whoa!
Now you can't rob the place now, can you? Now get!
Friendly old bastard, ain't you?
I don't need me no friends, friend.
We all need friends, old-timer. We die alone, but we live among men. You know, I was interested in moving out this way with my family. Would you be willing to sell me a parcel of land? We wouldn't even have to speak or nothing.
Land's too dry for farming. Bandits run all the cattle off. Why you want this land?
I guess I just like the scenery.
Well, I don't know. Maybe for $200 I could give you the deed to this land, find myself a place up in Blackwater. Although I never could stand the people down there. No, sir.
Okay, I'll take it.
Here you go then, partner. Good luck out here.
Here it is.
Yeah. Oh, there's blood on this deed, Marston. I didn't tell you to kill the poor old man. Here, take the money. That old bastard's got a son living up in Blackwater, so I'd be real careful not to publicize this sale too much. Unless killing entire families is a pleasure of yours, of course.
Good luck with the property, McAllister.
Yeah.
What the hell? I didn't even kill the guy.
Lord have mercy.
Oh, Lord, this is nasty. You stink. Thank you.
you eating?
Stay and sit a while.
There's much treasure here. You want map? I retire. Here, take map. You earn it.
I'll happily take this off your hands, my friend. I don't think you'll be wanting this no more, friend.
There's some errant wrongdoers down the way seem to have eluded us. Round them up or shoot them down.
Come! You gotta run faster than that. This fella's seen the error of his way.
You'll get along fine here, son. Now get gone.
Guess you owe me one.
What's happening here?
This'll fetch a good price. Got for me. Come on. Whoa there. There you are. There we go. That's one. Let's go. Yeah. here.